Ladies and gentlemen, Lauren Bacall.
I met Kirk Douglas at the American Academy of Dramatic Arts when I was 16 years old. Jailbait. Now, in getting ready for tonight, we asked the Academy if they had anything on Kirk in their files. And here is what they sent. Notes taken at his audition. Douglas, personality, pleasing. Proportion, good. And it was. Voice, fairly good. Reading, intelligent. Spontaneity, promising. Dramatic? Yes, they said, definitely. For once, an audition was right. He was beautiful at being bad. He was always the rebel. He didn't get into pictures as a pretty boy. It was the young fighter he played in The Champion who first said, I don't want to be a hey you. I want people to call me mister. I want to amount to something. Well, Kirk, you did it. You amounted to something. An American original, a hero with a thousand faces and a fiery, unforgettable spirit.
They're cheering more than a man tonight. They're cheering a story. The story of a boy who rose from the depths of poverty to become champion of the world.
One of seven children born to Russian Jewish immigrants, his name was Isur Danilovich. They lived at 46 Eagle Street in an upstate New York mill town, poorer than poor. His father, a peddler, a ragman, had traded in his dreams long ago. But Isur lived on dreams. He would be an actor. His mother, Bryna, told him, go. He hitchhiked to St. Lawrence University, talked his way into a scholarship, and grabbed the lead in every campus production. Two seasons of summer stock, and he was ready to go. Then he gave himself a new name. Douglas bought a one-way ticket to the only stage that counted. Broadway, where the big names played. He began to make a small name for himself, with small paychecks to match. Like it or not, he had to accept another offer. Heroes here were polished by the light, made larger than life, and endowed with perfection. A newcomer, Kirk was expected to fall in line. But against all advice, he agreed to a low-budget picture, drawn to the fury and fierceness of a character who spilled out from down deep within. Raw and untamed and exposed.
Did you hear that crowd? Here for the first time in my life, people cheering for me. You're deaf, didn't you hear them?
Listen, Haley. Those fat bellies with the big cigars are gonna make a monkey out of me. I can beat them. You know I can beat them.
Volatile and complex, he held back nothing.
Who gave you the right to dig into me and turn me inside out and decide what I'm like? How do you know how I feel about you, how deep it goes? Maybe I don't want anybody to own me, you or anybody. Get out! Get out! Get out!
When the studios flinched, he stepped in as star and producer. His anti-war Paths of Glory stands as a classic.
Sir, would you like me to suggest what you can do with that promotion?
Colonel Dax! You will apologize at once, or I shall be placed under arrest.
I apologize for not being entirely honest with you.
I apologize for not revealing my true feelings.
I apologize, sir, for not telling you sooner that you're a degenerate, sadistic old man.
And you can go to hell before I apologize to you now or ever again.
In more than 60 pictures, he never strayed from the theme that possessed him.
Because I'm a loner clear down deep to my very guts. You know what a loner is? He's a born cripple. He's crippled because the only person he can live with is himself. It's his life the way he wants to live it. It's all for him. A guy like that, he'd kill a woman like you. Because he couldn't love you. Not the way you are loved.
Kirk Douglas was always a little bit at war with everything. There was something dangerous about him, even a little frightening. But he compelled our attention because he was so willing to meet life head on.
Wait to get back to the old neighborhood, eh?
Yeah. I can't wait to see the old gang.
Think they'll recognize us?
Why not? We ain't changed.
Best things never do.
Damn right.
Ladies and gentlemen, Alan Alda, Ron Silver, and Tom Skerritt.
In The Ragman's Son, Kirk's autobiography, he wrote these words about his mother's reaction to his success in Hollywood. I said, Ma, guess what? I just signed a $1 million contract. She said, that's good, son. But is it steady work?
The intensity you see on the screen was something Kurt brought with him to the set every day. His pal, Burt Lancaster, put it this way. Kirk would be the first man to tell you that he's not an easy man to get along with, and I would be the second.
When you make 60 films, you're gonna get some raps along with the raves. When the raps came, Kirk said he took comfort with the words of Teddy Roosevelt. It's not the critic who counts. The credit belongs to the one who is actually in the arena, who at best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who, at the worst, fails while doing greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold, timid souls who know neither victory nor defeat.
Kirk ended his autobiography with this story. All my life, I knew I would be somebody. Didn't my mother tell me I was born in a gold box? I walk down the street, and a young woman stops me. I can spare a minute of my time for her. Perhaps she's a fan hoping for an autograph, or an actress who wants the benefit of my experience. She looks up at me adoringly. Her eyes, the color of jacaranda blossoms. I suck in my gut, puff out my chest, slap a bicep. Wow, she says, Michael Douglas's father.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Michael Douglas.
If you'd ask Dad what was his greatest production, he'd tell you it was his family. So, Dad, we'd like to acknowledge you tonight for the million miles that your life and your career has taken you. We're in awe of your destiny, the love you have for acting, the joy of making films. And when we were little kids, we saw the fun that you were having. And that's why we're not lawyers and accountants. You put celluloid in our genes. And on behalf of all your four sons, I want to thank you for that. From time to time, we would hear Dad hum this beautiful old Russian lullaby that his mother used to sing to him when he was putting him to sleep. It's a lovely song about almonds and raisins. And tonight, we have the Chevy Chase Elementary School Chorus who've learned to sing this song for you. And they're accompanied by the renowned world flautist, Paula Robeson.